What is good, YouTube? It is your boy, Be So Fitted. I'm back, and I'm better than ever. And today, I'm going to be bringing you an unboxing slash review on the Nike SB Jordan 1 Low Lance Mountain Desert Ore. That was a lot, but without further ado, let's get into this review. Here, we don't have a Jordan 1 box. We have a Nike SB box in a diamond and black colorway. This is very dope. It is nice to mix it up for once because my closet is getting filled with Jordan 1 boxes. But now, I can add a Nike SB box to my collection. So, here we'll get a closer look at the box. Here we got the QR code to ensure authenticity, so you can scan it and it'll take you right to the Nike website. And then we got a size 12, which is my personal size. A very dope box. I love the color combo. Very cool. I ordered this on Monday, which is when it came out, and it arrived today, which is the 11th, which is a Wednesday. So it came in 2 days, guys. For standard shipping from Nike, that is extremely fast, and I'm very pleased. Let's open up the box. Here we got the kicks. And then we got the Nike SB wrapping paper. It is very similar to the ones that you see on the OG Defiant, the LA to Chicago ones, which I'm wearing right now. Let's give you guys an up-close look. So in total, it came with three laces, the white ones that are already on the shoe, black ones, and blue ones. Here, the color that wears away is a UNC blue, and on the left shoe right here, the color that'll wear away is gonna be more of like a royal blue. I'm not quite sure yet how I'm gonna be able to wear the colors away because it is kind of like a khaki material. It is not leather, so I don't know if alcohol will do the trick. But I'm very pleased with the color scheme. It says Nike SB on the tongue, khaki color, UNC lining. And then actually, the insert's really dope. Here we have the insert. Really cool colors. It got the Zoom Air unit on the heel. Nothing crazy. For $130, I am very pleased with the result of the shoe and the way it looks. I knew from the colors and the pictures that I needed to have this shoe before it released. So, very dope. What I've been doing lately is I've actually been Sakai lacing my ones, so I'll show you what that looks like with these shoes on feet. Now, my thoughts and final review on the shoes, I'm very happy with the buy. I actually caught these on the sneakers app, and again, they're released on Monday, which is the 9th. Would I recommend paying resale for these? Actually, yeah, I would. I would pay out the door because StockX and GOAT's now charging tax. I would pay no more than about $170 to $180 out the door. Anything higher, then I have to really like the shoe. I do like these a lot, and I like how different they are. You're not really used to seeing khaki colors on Jordans, or shoes in general, but, you know, the color scheme is very dope. Very clean shoe. Now, if you guys are aware of who Lance Mountain is, I'll give you guys some background knowledge real quick. Lance Mountain is a skateboarder, and he actually decided to start skateboarding in Jordan 1s, but he did it differently, and he started mismatching his 1s. I believe he was skateboarding in some khaki pants and he was rocking some UNCs and some royal blue ones. This is actually Lance Mountain's third collaboration with Jordan. And the first two that came out are a pair of black high tops and a pair of white high tops. And the cool thing about those, the color actually wears away over time, or you can, you know, scratch the color away. So honestly, they've been doing this, the whole wear away thing with the Jordan 1s. So I actually already started doing that. The base color is purple, but once it wears away, it turns red. So Nike's been doing that. It's not really anything new, but for some reason, the hype and craze just got big out of nowhere. But it's something that's been around. And yeah, as far as Lance Mountain, that's pretty much my background knowledge on him. To be quite honest with you, I have never heard of him until, you know, he's been collabing with Jordan and Nike. I'm not too huge. Actually, I'm not into skateboarding at all, but I'm into the sneaker culture. I'm very into like collaborations and all that. So this is a nice little mix up. Now, let me show you guys what these look like on feet, and they will actually be Sakai laced. So let's check it out. All right, y'all, this is the on foot look at the shoes. And here you can see I Sakai laced my shit. You got black and blue and then white and blue on the other shoe. And then these are PacSun Skinny Fit black pants. I'm very pleased with the way the shoes look on foot. And I'm actually very happy with it being a low top. That way I can rock it with pants or shorts and they'll look clean either way. So, yeah, y'all, let me know in the comment section down below whether you guys rock with the Sakai lacing or whether or not you rock with the shoes, period. So, as you can see again, I Sakai laced my shoes real quick for you guys. So, yeah. And for the record, in case some of y'all aren't familiar with what Sakai is, Sakai is a Japanese brand that has been collabing with Jordan, and they're known for double layering all their features. So, if you look at one of their shoes, which is like the Sakai Blazers or the Sakai Waffles, you can see that they double lace all their shoes to go along with the double features on their kicks. If you're not sure what I'm talking about, go ahead and Google up Nike Sakai Blazers or Nike Sakai Waffles and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. But that is what inspired the idea for me to start double lacing my shoes. And yeah, that's it. As far as the unboxing and review slash on foot look at the Nike SB Jordan 1 Low Lance Mountain Desert Ore, that is all I have for you guys. Thank you so much, YouTube. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. As of that, that's it. It's your boy Be So Fitted. Stay saucy for me. Only way is up. We out, baby. Yes, you can. Well, I'm gone. Can I kick it? Yes, you can. Can I kick it? Yes, you can. Can I kick it? Yes, you can. Well, I'm gone.